It's possible for dogs. D-A-W-S-I-B-L-E, dog trainer extraordinaire. Siya mag-handle kay Mono the Chihuahua.
Oh, no.
Yeah, man. Excited na ako kung mangyayari kay Mono in the future.
Belated happy birthday.
Oo nga pala, no?
Happy birthday, Mono.
He's an adult na.
Oh, big, big boy. So, bro, dinala kita dito sa Creative Pickings because you are... You have to be creative para i-handle mga dogs. Not all people can handle dogs properly. Kaya sila pupunta sa'yo. Yeah. So, kamusta naman?
Yeah, so far so good. As always, we keep it positive as always. Yeah, so far, this year, first quarter was good for me. First quarter was very overwhelming. I wasn't expecting that much.
Maraming
clean. And then it's very ironic din na ang dami kong there was like last month as in puro aggressive case. So, parang feeling ko last month was like a threat sa akin na parang this will be the month na talagang masasaktan katawan mo. Parang ganun. But then again, yun, I had like roughly mga 10 aggressive cases last month.
Wow.
And they're all okay now. They're my friends now. And then we're talking of aggressive case talking. We're talking about aggressive towards dogs and humans. Okay. From smallest to the largest, talaga. Na dumating lahat like last month nandiyan sila lahat.
Yeah. Wow. So take us through the process. Pag merong, for example, may pumasok na aso na aggressive, anong ginagawa mo dito sa
it's That's possible? A good question. Most of the time they ask me, what's your approach? What's the process? What's the first thing to do? Okay. I never say na I'm going to do this type of training. This is the training method that I'm going to use dun sa aso niyan. Like I keep saying every day habang nakikita ko yung aso, I always shift or adjust dun sa lahat, gathering everything I know. Kasi if I stick to one, this might not work for this dog.
Iba-iba yung mga aso,
you know? Kaya you will never know talaga. Parang kala mo, let's say for example, you're done with this dog.
Uh-oh.
Tapos bigla sa mga, okay, bring it on, another one. I'll do the same thing. It's not like
Hindi
that.
Wow.
Bigla, it's
parang wala. Marami talaga trial and error.
Yeah, marami talaga. So, okay. I'm blessed with the experience of, yung years of experience ko as dog trainer. So I get to have maraming bala somehow.
Oh.
Yun. So it did help talaga.
Paano mo na develop yun? Kasi syempre at some point in time hindi ka dog trainer. Yeah. Di-develop mo. So paano mo nalaman na kaya mo gawin? Ano ginawa mo dati?
First and foremost, for love of dogs talaga.
Love
of animals, to be more specific. Yung curiosity ko na ano ba talaga yung ano yung tumatakbo sa utak nila, what will make them happy, what will make them comfortable. Tapos I would even to the point na nung bata ako, I would try yung let's say sa room ko, sa kwarto ko, I would try to make yung kwarto ko as dog friendly as possible, na not in a human way. Okay, ganun na yun ako dati, na parang yung hindi yung gusto ko, feeling ko yung parang nasa wild sila, yung ganun. So I will set it up na to make them feel na parang so then doon ko sila naiintindihan. Which would they prefer? Would they prefer a bed or sa ilalim lang ng ganito? Parang yung simple things like that. It started that way. Of course, maraming times I get bitten, I get parang yung I broke yung bond ko with the dog. Because I thought it was supposed to be like this. Ito yung tinisip na when tas mali pala ako. So that's how I think it progressed from that.
So just taking care of dogs, developing relationships, tapos kailan mo na-realize na, wow, pwede ito maging career? Pwede ito maging trabaho?
to be honest, I never really planned it or I never really look at it that way.
Mm-hmm.
Until lang nung I started to get paid na. Nang hindi ako naningil talaga at all. Tapos they were saying, no, that's an effort. You spend time dun sa aso. I couldn't, yung patience mo is way above dun sa ano ko. Yung mga sinasabi ng mga dog owner, sabi na, no, I'm paying you.
Wow.
Yan, tapos I got that from foreign friends.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi they know how it yung effort niya dun sa ganyang klaseng
syempre.
Ano. Oh, di ba? Tapos sila yun na, no, you should get paid. You should get this. Okay, I'll give you this. Or can you just, can you just look after my dog? Or if I'll leave you my dog like every once in a while, pero I'll pay you monthly. Parang mga ganun.
Oh.
So just to be there for their dog. So then, yung business went in.
Parang sunod-sunod na pagkatapos. So, more or less, parang by accident, or tinawag, parang calling mo yun,
Yeah.
Tinawag ganun, ng trabaho. Ganun. Pero ka rin, parang kung ano, baka pwede ito.
Exactly. I just had to, be more, na dun sa business side nun, kasi nga, yun nga, practicality. Mm. It's taking my time na. It's taking up my time na. So sabi ko, okay, so let's think business. Then, yeah, so that's how it started talaga.
Nice. Bro, let's talk about dogs and owners. Kasi yun yung napag-usapan rin natin dati, di ba, nung tinitignan mo si Mono. Most of the time, the problem isn't always the dog. It's actually the owner or the master.
Yeah.
No? So paano naayos yun? Di ba? Kasi syempre yung aso yung naayos mo, pero minsan yung owner rin. So you kind of have to be a psychologist, psychiatrist, di ba? Parang...
Exactly. Of course, beforehand, of course, you have to be on the same page with the owner talaga.
Oh, diba?
Bago pa lang pumasok yung aso na yan, they have to understand na if pag-usapan lang natin aso, I don't put it in writing na I'll guarantee this, pero I will guarantee you na I've been there, done that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I've handled hundreds of dogs already. So I make it clear sa kanila na the only thing for this to work is your part. Okay, so lagi kong sinasabi. Sometimes it's most of the time it's very difficult to unlearn. Yun, sabi ko, so you will unlearn a lot of things in terms of taking care of dogs and understanding dogs and communicating with dogs. So basically, sinasabi ko sa kanila, this will be more on me talking, di ba? So you have to listen, you have to have an ear for that, you have to have patience with that, for that, so para to make it work. So yun, talagang, clients would come here, they're like from, yung mga, we have like doctors, lawyers, and sometimes it's hard to break it to them na, no, you listen. You know what I'm saying?
Oh.
So they have to have that.
They have to,
exactly, yeah, and there you said it already. So yeah. They have to have
sorry,
that.
Sorry, guys.
That's the truth. Sometimes it's, since he said it already, it's difficult to tell somebody who's of a higher, you have to shut up first.
Oh.
Shut up, listen first. Because besides, this is my craft, this is my field.
Kaya kayo muna kay Mike, kasi may problema kayo sa aso.
Exactly.
Kung doktor ka, di ba, imagine mo may sakit ka, tapos inaawa mo yung doktor mo, hindi, wala yung sakit, edi ba't kayo nandito?
Exactly. So, kulang na sabihin mo dun sa ano, kulang na sabihin mo dun sa kanya. O sige, ano sakit mo?
Oo, hindi na
nung di galawin, di gamutin mo sarili mo. Alam mo pala eh. Parang ganun.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you're the dog doctor, in a sense, di ba? Parang tinatry mo ayusin based off your experience. Marami kang matatrial and error. Let's try different things. Kasi, actually, di ba totoo rin naman for doctors, di ba? If they diagnose you, they have to do several tests.
Yeah.
Bakit makabuksan yung katawan mo, we have to do x-ray, we have to do all these different things. Same for a dog trainer.
Exactly.
Diba?
Tapos yun din, ang pinaka-importante dun is, what was I gonna say? Yung, ang dami nating dog trainers dito na, I mean, talagang saludo ako sa kanila. Okay. I talk to them. I learn from them also. So they ask for advice from me. So it, para sa akin, it's a give and take sa bawat dog trainers. And no doubt, madaming magaling na dog trainers dito. Pero, how come ang nagiging end result is walang nagiging parang hindi naging maayos yung aso. Okay? Ang point ko dito is, it's not because of the dog trainers, it's not the dog trainers' fault. It just goes to show na it's really about the owners. Okay? I've had, like I think like 3 weeks ago, I had an aggressive case. Oh. Tapos, she said the dog just came from another dog trainer. They were saying about, she was telling me about kung ano yung naging issue, blah, 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 whatever. Sabi ko, for me, sabi ko, regardless na yan kung ano yung ano na yan. Okay, kasi, there is no special ano na parang, siguro meron konti lang. Pero we all have like foundation lang na a pattern that we follow. Okay? Mm-hmm. So, for all you know, yung ginagawa ko dito, same thing na ginagawa lang din ng iba. Pero it's just a matter of, ang tanong is, ako gagawin ko sa aso mo, you will see results. Pero how about you and your dog? So it's not gonna work na. So anyway, ang nangyari dito is good thing. Fortunately, yung aso and the owner, so sabi ko, you have to understand na since galing na pala sa ibang trainer yan, then that's good. Less load sa akin. Okay, but more talking sa part ko, between you and I. Sabi ko, mas marami tayong time mag-uusap. Mas marami akong hihingin commitment sa'yo. You have to visit often or we have to, creates scenarios for you and your dog. So, kasi nandiyan na eh. Magaling na siya. Mm. Okay, it's just that meron siyang konting problema na hindi natin ma-fix because it's the owner's part this time. So, yun, they graduated. They graduated like two days ago. So, yun. So, ang ganda nung ano. Tapos now, she became parang she's been posting, and I sent her a text last night. Uh-huh. Sabi ko, you don't have an idea how proud I am of you. Aww. Sabi ko kasi, galing. You're sending, parang, sabi ko, now yung dog training secrets, inilalabas mo na ngayon sa Facebook. Uh-huh. And it makes me happy kasi yung videos mo, when you're posting it, you have instructions, yung nagiging instructional video siya. Tapos yung mga comments mo, the dog did this because blah, 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 blah. Mm. So parang, I'm parang super saya ko noon na nakita ko sa kanya na talagang pumasok dito sa kanya. Siya na yung nagagawa ng excuse for her dog, for failing. Mm. When in fact, before, tingnan mo, he moved. He cannot stay. He cannot do this. He's so stubborn. That's the magic word. I hate hearing that sa owner. Stubborn. He's stubborn. Oh. Now the yung aso they move, sabi niya, see, he moved because ganto, this was my fault. See? Yeah. So they become na-achieve natin dito sa it's possible, yung greatest na yung goal ko talaga is for my owners, not just to be owners, they become handlers, they become trainers.
Yes.
Ayun. So,
sabihin ko nga sana yun, dun ka rin na iba sa tingin ko, compared to other trainers, is you're actually training the owners to be like you. Para yeah. Pag iniyaw mo na kami, kasama ang aso namin, kaya pa.
Exactly.
Kasi ang lungkot na, di ba? Like, if the dog only listens when you're around, tapos pag kami na, ba't nyo na kaya? Nawala yung magic.
Exactly. Di ba? Yun, talaga. So, on a business aspect, that's good sa akin. Kasi, hanggang hindi ka nakikinig, every time you see my face, I go to your house, that's money. Di ba?
Maayos siya para sa'yo.
Eh, pero business, ano yan, ano yung business aspect, ano yung business aspect sa akin, that's fine. Sige, oh. Keep it coming. Sige,
pero hindi, di ba?
Be more stubborn.
Oh, di ba?
Hindi pero hindi, hindi yung hindi. Mano ko. So,
yeah. Kasi ano naman yung fulfillment din for you and for the client. Parang yes, binabayaran mo siya. Pero parang nagiging babysitter ka na. That's not
exactly.
The goal, diba?
Exactly.
Yeah. Pero, kwento mo naman, Mike, with regards to dogs, dahil iba-iba ang breeds, iba-iba ang styles, iba-iba ang owners, or actually, to be more specific, yung mga aggressive dogs, kasi recently you had a few aggressive dogs, what, without giving everything away, like, what do you actually do to slowly fix their aggressiveness?
Ito yan. Okay. There's two types of aggression. Mm. One is yung fear aggression, which is very common. Hmm. And yung isa is, I'm just confident. I'm territorial. I'm overprotective. I'm gonna bite you.
Hmm.
Okay. So, with, pag ganyan ang ano natin, ang case natin, that's very easy to fix. For me, ha? Para sa akin, that's ano na. Pero what's more challenging is yung fear-aggressive na aso.
Hmm.
Okay. So, here's a tip. Mostly what other trainers do, so I don't know if I should say that, ha? Pero I believe kasi na, alam mo naman tayo, Pilipino, we ano, ginagawa nating guideline natin si, like foreign countries, yung mga popular ones, sa YouTube, yung mga ganyan. Then just ano, meron tayong very, yung famous na si, ano, si Dog Whisperer, sa ibang bansa.
Yeah.
And he's been dealing with ano, talaga aggressive case. Okay, so I feel sad na we got influenced with that kind of ano, too much.
Oh, okay,
without really understanding what's happening with the dog. Okay. I'm not saying it's not a good approach. It is one of the many approach. Pero parang since it became so popular, it became ano na parang that's one, that's the only approach to be done. Okay, so siguro yun yung isa dun sa akin na I'm not saying I don't do that approach.
Mm-hmm.
Selective yan. It's a case to case basis, depende sa aso. But when I deal with fear aggression, from the word itself na nga, they're gonna bite because they are fearful. Okay, they don't trust no one, they don't trust this sound, they don't trust that object, they don't trust you.
Mm-hmm.
They think you're going to hurt them, diba? So if you do that kind of approach, which yung kung ano yung popular, it's like confirming sa aso, it's like confirming na I am here to hurt you. Kasi what is happening dun sa approach na, that's dominance-based na approach. So you get it. So parang, so, yun yung tip. Yun yung ano ko dun na, bahala na kayo mag-elaborate na, isipin nyo na lang yan. Pero yun yung exactly, of course, for example, tayong dalawa, you're not going to bite me. You're not going to fight me.
Mm-hmm.
Because, denominate kita eh.
Mm.
What happens if siya? So if she follows my lead, or she thought na it's you're fixed. She thought you're fixed already.
Mm-hmm.
Then she follows. Kung ano ginawa ko, I tap you here. Of course you're not gonna fight me, kasi dominated na kita. Kasi yun, di ba? Parang oh, ayoko si Mike. Takot dyan. Tigla akong siniko niyan sa ano eh. Okay. So, paghawak ko sa iyo, medyo, it's okay. Touch me, I don't care. But she tries it to you.
Iba.
You will definitely fight her. So, it's not, kaya nga sabi ko, ang hirap sabihin eh, hindi ko sinasabing wag nilang panoorin ng panoorin niya.
Diba?
You watch it, pero be very careful. That's
hindi
ano,
nakakatakot.
Actually, it's going to hurt yung mga watchers. talaga yung mga viewers niyan.
Yeah.
Kaya yun. So ako, even ako sa mga videos ko, I don't mind sharing. I don't mind sabihin ko, breakdown ko pa talaga yan. Kasi I'm after yung welfare ng aso. And of course, prime first and foremost, yung safety ng owners. Mm-hmm. Di ba? I mean, mukha lang ano, yung kagat-kagat na yan. Pero it hurts.
Yeah.
Sakit talaga yan, especially dito sa mga kamay na yan.
Saka nakakaawa rin syempre sa aso eh. Kasi isipin mo, the reason they're like that, technically dahil sa owners eh.
Diba? Exactly.
Ayaw nakakamay.
Exactly. Most of the time, it's how they were raised.
Yeah.
It's how they were raised.
Kaya sila naging ganun. Para mga bata rin, para ng mga tao eh. Like, meron ako sinabing na gusto ko eh, quotable quotes to eh. Treat dogs like dogs.
Yeah. Treat dogs like dogs. Treat animals as animals.
Mm.
Okay. The same thing din sa atin. We wouldn't want to be treated as animals. Even though I give you the best dog food, Zio. I give you a golden bed, but it's a dog bed. I'm telling you, Zio, pare, galing sa ano yan. Okay? Diba? Diba? Parang... Diba? Para sa akin, I will get offended nang hindi ka masaya.
Hindi ka masaya. Oh.
Samantang siya, gold yan eh. Pero dog bed, lagay mo sa kwarto mo. Diba? You get my point. So, same thing din with sa aso. You don't need the most expensive, let them be dogs. And, tapos, aside from dun, is of course, para ma-break yung communication barrier nyo, yung communication gap ninyo, okay? Mm. Once you start treating your dog as a dog, that's the time bigla kayo may communication.
Mm-hmm.
So that's good bond.
Yeah.
Hindi pwedeng masyadong one-sided yung relationship, okay? One-sided yung relationship. Gusto mo lang just to show off your dog. So lagyan mo siya ng hair pin, whatever, lagyan mo lang kung ano-ano. That's nice. Bili ako ng pinaka-expensive na damit para sa aso. Tapos lumabas kayo sa TV, yung aso mo, ikaw ka ganun ka, okay, astig. Nice, yung aso ko, pero yung aso mo, hindi na makahinga yung balat ko, yung mga ganun.
Yeah, diba? So, happy ko talaga ang dog kung
exactly,
may damit sila.
Exactly, yung mga ganun.
Hard to
so,
say.
Yeah.
Minensyo ko kasi yung sinama, treat dogs like dogs. Kasi, mayroong mga misconceptions about how dogs should be treated. May fine line eh. From what I see socially, na when you train a dog or when you try to get a dog to be like a dog and have a good relationship with you, some people sinasabi nila, dapat hindi mo ninuneuter, dapat hindi mo sinispay, dapat hindi mo sinisigawan ng ganyan, or you know, you shouldn't scare them or even potentially be physical. Mm-hmm. Pero sa tingin ko, because you're treating them like animals, and they're there to complement your life and to have a good relationship. Sana yun yung goal ng mga tao when they get pets, hopefully, is to have a good relationship. Minsan kailangan eh.
Oo, yes. It's a matter of dogs learn by association.
Yeah.
Yun, ganun lang kasimple yun. Dogs learn by association. So, if this is bad behavior for you, you can mark it as bad behavior by giving consequence.
Mm-hmm.
But make sure it's like on point. So, because by association, alam mo na yan. So, parang ganun. So, it's okay for me. Para sa akin, it's okay to, yun nga, yung sinabi mo kanina na you get physical with them, yung mga ganyan. So, it's really a matter of, yun nga, how you mark it.
Oh.
Yan. Marking is the key dun sa dog training.
So in a sense, may proper way to do it.
Exactly. Diba? Exactly. You go,
kung yun lang sa aso, kung meron siya ginawang mali, kasi hindi rin tama yun eh. Kailangan tignan yung sarili mo.
Mm. So yun ang maano dun. So you attend my seminars.
Yes. Yes.
You attend my seminars and I'll tell you that.
Same reality eh. Most people just allow their dogs, at least yung mga, ang dami ko nakikita eh, sa ako nakatira na maraming mga aso, like, they're in a leash and dogs are just going crazy. Tapos sa mga owners, parang, hindi, okay lang yan kasi, you know, he or she is my baby, it's fine. Pero kung na-decrease yung quality of life mo with your...
Exactly.
Best friend.
Exactly.
Parang, sige, diba?
One point.
Ba't ako nagsasuffer? Binili ko tong aso para magkasama ko.
Exactly.
But, making my life hell. Sometimes.
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah, totoo yan. So, it's also a matter of din ano man that's why here we do ano yung we yung isa dun sa service namin is yung we select for yung mga owners na what na bibili pa lang ng aso. So I assess their lifestyle.
Yun, oh.
I assess ano bang ginagawa nyo.
Well, magandang service yun ah. So before they buy,
They buy, they come to me. I check, talaga bang pagdating dito, kita mo naka jogging pa. Saka mo sporty ka. Tapos yun pala, get up lang ngayon for that day. Tapos yun, sabi niya sa akin, no, I'm very active person. I bike, I run, I do this, blah, blah, blah. Yung pala, when I want. So, hindi ako natapos na ako sa I do this, kanya, okay, sige, that's what you want. So, let's buy a Labrador. Let's buy a Belgian Malinois para active lifestyle. Eh, no. Tapos biglang yung pala, ang hindi niya nasabi sa akin, when I want lang. Pag trip ko lang tumakbo.
Once a month lang pala.
Once a month. So, tapos ngayon, so you end up with the aso na, wow, hell talaga, biglang katawag ko sa'yo, yung aso, too much for me.
Eh, hindi mo nilalabas yun.
Kala ko active ka eh, sorry. So, ganun. So, yun yung mga, kaya, that's very important na you have to know your lifestyle, even yung residence nung ano kung saan siya nakatira, yung paligid niya, yung environment, yung access niya to fields, to mga ganyan. So you have to take that in consideration.
Tama. Yeah,
so yun. So kailangan ganun.
Yun. Actually gusto ko yun, Mike. To lead into my last question, parang inumpisahan mo na rin eh. What advice would you give to new dog owners and dog owners in general? Kasi nakita mo na lahat eh. Di ba?
Yeah.
Okay. Pero yeah. If you could give us some your best tips.
Patience. Tapos it's always it's always the owner, not the dog.
It's always the owner, not the dog.
It's always the owner. Whatever it is na poproblemahin nyo. There's training first for certain ano. Okay? And sa training, you need patience lang talaga. And very important is you have to trust yung process. That's one thing na lagi kong inaano. I have trainers, I have clients who are the brink of I give up. After lahat na ng mga binigay mong tips sa kanya, advice mo, lahat na ng mga sessions mo, they agree. Pero it's about hanggang saan sila. Okay? So they tend to parang I want to give up na. So I keep telling them, no, trust the process. Parang they feel na, sige, I understand, I know what you're saying. It's very factual, it's very, by experience mo, tama. But, parang sa akin, ako, I'm the one who's hopeless, gaganan sila. But I don't know, just trust the process. I've been saying that many times, and it has became, yung biruan ng lahat ng mga clients ko. I have 100 clients na already na talagang sila minsan pag may nagko-comment sa akin sa Facebook. Yung mga iba na sabi, my dog is like this, my dog is that, or magko-comment sa videos ko na that dog will not learn, basta ganyan ganyan. Minsan mga clients ko, no, just trust the process. So kasi they've been there, done that, they've experienced, they've seen the beauty.
Yun.
No, they've seen the beauty ng dog training talaga.
Yung change.
Yun. So yun. Yan, that's it. Patience, tapos trust the process. I don't give timelines eh. Totoo lang, I don't give timelines sa owner na your dog is gonna finish at this date. Yep. No, I cannot say that. Kasi I work on the dog's timeline.
Yes.
I work on the dog's timeline. If I work on my timeline, then yun na kagad, yun na yung recipe to failure.
Recipe for failure, man.
Oo, kasi it means, stick lang ako dun sa ano ko. Parang kunyari, Mono, bahala ka. Ito yung alam ko, kailangan matapos mo. Hindi. May mga ganun. So, you have to understand yung aso mo. And be fair sa aso. Okay? Look at it this way. If you're finding you are having a hard time teaching a dog like a certain specific lang na one thing lang. Tapos you think it's taking too much time already. Okay, tapos you start blaming your dog. Stubborn, slow, cannot process, blah, 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 blah. Look at us being humans na tayo nga, we have to go through nursery, kinder, grade school, elementary, high school, college. Man, that's a long process.
Mas malala
diba, mas matalino tayo sa mas matalino tayo sa kanila, di ba? Oh, how come? Tapos ganyan, sabihin mo sa akin, una yung aso ko, I give up. Ha? Are you kidding me? Diba? Do you get my point? Yan, so yan. So yun lang. Just patience talaga. Patience.
Tama, yeah. Brother. Actually, Mike, gusto ko talaga kasi you're very realistic and people should realize that. Yung sinabi mo tungkol sa timing with dogs, just the fact na sinabi mo walang timeline ng dogs, ibig sabihin ng like, no BS, man. You're just there to really help. So guys, if you need help with your dog, please check out It's Possible with Mike Muyco. This guy will give it everything he has to help you and your dog. So
yes, big up.
Bro, thank you, man.
Thank you. Nice one.